Hey guys, hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss one of the name reaction, that is a Wagner and Mervyn rearrangement reaction. Now what I said here, that is a rearrangement reaction. Before starting this topic, we must know what are the rearrangement reaction. The rearrangement reaction are the reaction in which some atoms or a group of a substrate shift or a migrate from one position to the another position within a molecule, giving rise to the product with a new structure that we call as a rearrangement reaction. So this Wagner and Mervyn rearrangement reaction is a kind of the rearrangement reaction. So let us have a look towards the statement of this reaction. Now let us have a look towards the statement of this reaction. The Wagner and Mervyn rearrangement is a class of the carbocation rearrangement, or it is also known as a 1-2 rearrangement reaction, in which the hydrogen, alkene or aryl group migrate from the one carbon to the neighboring carbon. It means that these rearrangement reaction involve the migration of either hydrogen, either alkene or aryl group from one carbon to the another carbon. This rearrangement reaction is also known as cationic 1-2 sigma tropic rearrangement. So after seeing the statement of this reaction, let us have a look towards the rearrangement scheme. That is, what is the scheme of this reaction? Now the first step, what we can see over here is a generation of the carbocation. As we already seen that this rearrangement reaction is due to the electron deficient carbon. The electron deficient carbon is nothing but it is a carbocation. So first step in this rearrangement reaction involves the generation of the carbocation. Here in this reaction scheme, you can see here the carbocation is get generated but from the alcohol by the treatment of the acid. Now what happened in the first step over here, this we know that this oxygen contain the lone pair of the electron. As this oxygen contain the lone pair of the electron, and we are adding acid in the reaction, so this acid will protonate this oxygen. After protonation, what will be the next step? Here, as oxygen donate its lone pair to the H+, here the oxygen will carry the positive charge, and we know that the oxygen is highly electronegative. It can't bear the positive charge on itself. So this group will be free as a stable water molecule, and we will get a carbocation. You can see here beside we are getting the carbocation. Now you can see here this carbocation which is get formed, which is a primary carbocation. We know that while discussing the stability of the carbocation, the tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary than primary. So in this molecule there is a chance of formation of the tertiary carbocation, but how? By migrating this group towards this primary. If we say it has an alpha and this beta, if we break this alpha beta bond, then what will happen over there? That this group will migrate towards this carbocation, and here there will be the formation of the cation. And this cation is highly stable. Why? Because this is a tertiary carbocation. As this carbocation contain a 3CH3 group carbon attached, so this is called as a tertiary carbocation. And the tertiary carbocation are more stable as compared to the primary carbocation. So here migration occur, and this migration is known as a rearrangement. The migration which is happening over here due to the electron deficient carbon, which is called as a rearrangement reaction. As in the solution, as we use the acid, so the nucleophile is present over there. So this nucleophile will attack, and we will get this as a final product. So in this reaction scheme, we generate the carbocation by using the alcohol. But there are also the another way to generate the carbocation. We can also generate from the halide, that is by using a strongly ionizing solvent or adding a Lewis acid such as a silver ion. And thirdly, we can also generate the carbocation by the alkene, by the process of the protonation, and also from the amine. There are the various ways to generate the carbocation in the Wagner and Mervyn rearrangement reaction. In this reaction scheme, we discuss the generation of the carbocation from the alcohol. So now let us discuss some of the example of this rearrangement reaction. In this example, you can see here there is an OH present, and this OH contain a lone pair. Again, the acidic medium is provided, it will get protonated, As it will get protonated, it will form OH2. This OH2 will be free as a stable water molecule, and here there will be the formation of the cation. As we know, the alkyl group can migrate. This alkyl group can will migrate over here. As in the system, there is a no presence of the nucleophile. So simple, the elimination will take place. Elimination will take place, and we will get this as our final product. Then, now let us see the second example. In the second example, similarly, here the acidic medium is get provided. It will get protonated. After protonation, this group will be free. As this group, water will be free, and there will be the formation of the cation. So this is the alpha bond. This is a beta bond. We know that the four member ring are quite unstable. So this alpha and beta, this bond will be break, and at the position of the alpha, the cation will be formed. As this four member ring will break, we will get, that is, a ring expansion will occur, and we will get a five member ring, and there will be the cation. As in the system, the Br as a nucleophile is present, because H plus and Br minus, and Br minus will act as a nucleophile over here, and we will get this as a product. Whenever there is a chance of the ring expansion and we are getting a stable ring, then at that time the ring expansion will occur. Now similarly, you can see here, this is another example. As here, the looking to the another example, here there is a, this is a kind of the same example. Just here the alkene, it is a source of the carbocation generation. Here what will happen over here, this bond will shift over here, there will be formation of the cation, and then alpha beta bond will break to form the stable radical, and after that the water, which is present as a nucleophile in the system, will act over here, and we will get this as our product. You can try the mechanism of this reaction by your own. So this is a example which is example of the Wagner and Mervyn rearrangement reaction, which is a previous year gate question. As here the acidic medium is provided, and this oxygen contains a lone pair, it will get protonated. After protonation, the electrophilicity of this carbonyl center increases, and this bond will shift over here, and here there will be the formation of the cation. So the carbon atom next to the cation, which we call as an alpha and beta, this ring is a four member ring. Again, the ring expansion will take place, and we will get a cation at alpha position, and beta will join to this previous position, previous cationic position. And we know that here, if we see this cation is tertiary, we can say it as unstable, but there is again one more chance to stabilize this carbocation, that is by the back bonding. We know that the back bonding stabilizes the carbocation more. So here again, this alpha and this beta, again this bond will be break, and we will get this as a product. Okay, here in this is again one of the example from the Wagner and Mervyn rearrangement reaction. So here alcohol is there. Again, this oxygen carry the lone pair, it will get protonated. Here after the protonation, it will form OH2+, and after the formation of the OH2+, this group will be free, and here there will be the formation of the cation. Again, after the cation, this will be alpha bond, this will be beta bond, the ring expansion will take place, and the six member ring is formed. After the six member ring, as there is no nucleophile in the system, the elimination will take place, and we will get this as our product. So hope you understand with this rearrangement reaction. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel for more such useful content. Thanks for watching this video.